Hello guys, I'm Kuldeep Singh Sekhon. Today I'm going to demonstrate how to deploy your web application or website to the Heroku app cloud. And I have demonstrated all this process on my blog javaexperthub.blogspot.in. You may refer this with this tutorial. So first of all, go to the heroku.com and create your account on the Heroku app cloud. It's a fairly simple. Give your name, last name, email, etc. and choose the language. I choose the Java and create account. So Heroku tool cloud, Heroku app cloud support many languages. You may choose any one if you want, but this time I'm going to choose Java application development. So let us start. The first requirement for the deploying your application is to Heroku tool belt, and you may Google it and download it from the heroku.com. It's Heroku tool belt. It's fairly simple to install the Heroku tool belt. Simply click next and full installation and next. I have already installed, so that's why I'm not going to install this. Now we have our account on Heroku and also install the tool belt. The next step is login to your Heroku account through the command prompt. Go to command prompt, press Heroku. Heroku login. And it's asking the credential of your account. Give the password. Now I am logged in with my account, and let us see, it's my demo application which I have developed with the Maven. And if your application is not in the Maven, then please convert it into the Maven and find out the pom.xml. A demo is demonstrated over here, or you may find out on the Google also. So it's a fairly simple, it's a sample pom.xml. Create it and add your dependency in it. So thereafter you need to add one plugin in this pom.xml file. This is web app runner. The web app runner actually deploy your application in the Tomcat container, and its version is tied up with the Tomcat version. So I am going to use 8.0.30.2 version of the web app runner. So it means that it's going to deploy your application in the Tomcat 8.0.302 version. So open up the pom.xml file of your project. And add this plugin in the plugin section. So you may copy this code from my blog also, and it's also available on the Heroku also. You may note it. You may pause it, the video, and note it, or you may find it on the my blog. It's also available over there. So next step is create one proc file. So proc file must have this line. Please paste this line and save this file in the same project folder. and do not give any extension to this file. Select all files and save. Now this file has no extension, and this is basically is to run the web app runner on the Heroku cloud, and we have added this plugin, and this plugin will be run by the Heroku cloud by the help of this file, with the help of this file. Now convert your project into Git project. Simply write git init. Now git is initialized your project in your project. Now add all files in your repository. Now commit git commit and message first commit to deploy, or any message you want to give. So now next step is create one app in your Heroku account. You may see I have no application till now in my account. It's a new, and let us create one. Go to Heroku, create, and let us say example web, or any name which is available. The name is already taken. Let us change it with some other name. Web app 1616 and enter. I hope this name will be available, and done. The Heroku has created your app with this name, and now it's time to deploy your app on the Heroku. I think it's going very wrong, and now let us deploy your app on the Heroku. Git push, and in normal git push it's a region and master branch, but in case of Heroku this origin is replaced with Heroku. Now it's pushing your application to the web, to the server of Heroku. So it's remote Java app detecting and installing OpenJDK 1.8 and so on and so. If all is correct, then it will deploy your application, push your application to the Heroku cloud, and on the Heroku cloud it will download all the dependency and compress your file into a WAR package. Now build is successful. My application has successfully pushed into the Heroku cloud. But one thing is still pending, that we have to run at least one Heroku. I think I must clear it. You must run one Heroku instance. Now dyno install is scaling, and now running web at one free dyno install instance. Now you may give the command Heroku open and Heroku open. It will open up your application which you have recently created, and web app 1616, and how to deploy a Java website on the Heroku app cloud. And I have demonstrated all this on this, and this is a sample application having only one page, and this is the procedure I have demonstrated all the procedure on my blog. There are two more ways by which we can deploy our application on the Heroku cloud. That is through GitHub. We may directly push our application from the Git to the Heroku cloud, and also we can deploy a WAR file to the Heroku cloud. Now let us examine, refresh this account, and let us check whether the application has moved to the Heroku cloud. Though we have checked it, but let us make it confirm. So it's taking some time. I think my it's taking too much time. Let us refresh it. Now it's opening. Yes, this is my recently deployed application. Let us open it. And this is deployed on 3 minutes ago. 3 minutes ago, and these are the resources which are allocated to it. And it's a same line which we have written in the proc.xml file. Sorry, proc file, not XML. It's a simply proc file. It's a Java ops, and this button is on, and we make it through this command, this Heroku ps scale web 1. And this is setting tab. In setting tab, you may check that it's the same name. You may change this name with the any name, and it's acquiring 56 MB of 300 MB of size. And this is the link of the, you may add the permanent, you may add your domain over here. It's the subdomain, a free domain which Heroku given to you, but you may add your domain. I hope you learn from this video and enjoyed this video. And in the subsequent video, I will tell you how to link your account with the GitHub and directly transfer your application from the GitHub to the your Heroku account. So thank you for today, and please do not forget to subscribe subscribe my channel and like my video. And I will come back again with the next method of the deploying application to the Heroku cloud. Thank you so much.